Today we are going to talk about judicial system. In 1772, the dual government was abolished and the company took over the direct responsibility for the collection of revenue as well as the administration of justice. Consequently, a Diwani Adalat and Faujari Adalat were established. By the Regulating Act of 1773, a Supreme Court was set up in Calcutta. This court consisted of a Chief Justice and three puissant judges who were appointed by the Crown. This court decided civil, criminal and admiralty cases. On the model of the Supreme Court of Calcutta, a Supreme Court was established in Madras in 1801 and in Bombay in 1823. In 1832, William Bentinck started jury system in Bengal. A Indian Law Commission was established to compile the laws. A rule of law was established for the whole empire. According to the Indian High Court Act 1861, three high courts were set up in Calcutta, Bombay and Madras in place of the old Supreme Courts. Okay. Judicial system. In 1772, the dual regime, so that is dual government. So in 1772 only the dual government was abolished in India. And the English East India Company adopted the power to collect taxes. So in 1772 the dual government was first time in India abolished. After abolished the English East India Company adopted the power. What power? Adopted the one important power. So power to collect taxes and administer justice. Yeah, taxes, collecting taxes powers. Okay. And then the result was the creation of the Diwani, also known as What does it mean by Diwani? So Diwani, also known as the civil court and the Baujdari Adlat and the criminal court. Okay. So the result was the end of the result, creation of the Diwani. Diwani also, there are two courts, one is civil court, another one is criminal court. Civil court also known as Diwani and the criminal court also known as Baujdari Adalat. So Diwani Adalat, Faujdari Adalat. The Supreme Court was established in Calcutta in 1773. So that is the first time, okay. The first time the Supreme Court was established in Calcutta when 1773 under a regularity law, under a normal regularity law, okay. The British King appointed a Chief Justice. So the British King only appointed a Chief Justice. Chief Justice means, yeah, judge, yeah. The Supreme British King appointed the Chief Justice and three deputy judges to the court. The court heard civil and so many cases. And like the Supreme Court in Calcutta, the Supreme Court was established in Madras 1801. After that, like the Supreme Court in Calcutta, so Calcutta like the Supreme Court madriye, in 1801 in Madras Supreme Court was established, and then in 1823 the Supreme Court was established in Bombay also. After that, in 1832, Lord William Pending introduced one jury system to Bengal. Okay, so in 1832, Lord William Pending introduced one jury system to Bengal. The Law of Commission of India was set up to compile laws. So the rule of law was enforced throughout the canton. So the High Court Act of 1861 established three High Courts to the replace Supreme Court at Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. So in 1861, so the High Court Act, so that is one rule, the High Court Act when 1861 established three High Courts only. So three High Courts, but to replace the Supreme Court. So Supreme Court, instead of, to replace the Supreme Court, then they established the three high courts in Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. the subsidiary alliance. The subsidiary alliance, very very important one. Lord Wellesley introduced the system of subsidiary alliance to bring the princely states under the control of the British. It was the most effective instrument for the expansion of the British territory and the political influence in India. The princely state was called the protected state, and the British came to be referred as the paramount power. It was the duty of the British to safeguard the state from external aggression and to help its ruler in maintaining internal peace. So the subsidiary alliance, which means paramilitary project. Okay, so that this system, this alliance, the subsidiary alliance, was the plan introduced by the Wellesley, Lord Wellesley. Why? To bring the princely state. So the subsidiary alliance introduced. So subsidiary alliance, a plan introduced by the Lord Wellesley to why? To bring the princely state in India under the British control only. Okay. So to bring the princely state. So to bring the princely state in India under the British control. This project was a major tool. This project was a major tool in expansion British rule and establishing political dominance in India. So this subsidiary alliance, this subsidiary alliance is a major tool in expanding the British rule and establishing the political dominance. So for the two things, so one is expanding British rule in India and establishing the political dominance in India. So after that, princely states were called protected states. So after princely states were controlled under the British, they were called protected states, because all the princely states were protected by British only. So the British had supreme powers over those states. The British had a supreme powers over those states compared to these kings. It was the major duty of the British. What is the main duty of the British? To protect the princely states and to maintain reach in the interior. To protect the princely states and to maintain the peace in the interior. Main features of subsidiary alliance. Main features of subsidiary alliance. An Indian ruler entering into this alliance with the British had to dissolve his own armed forces and accept British forces. So the Indian king joining the plan, the Indian king joining the plan was to disband his army and join the British army only. Suppose the Indian king wants to join the British, means the Indian king had to disband his own army and join to the British army. This is the first condition. So what is the first condition? Suppose the Indian king wants to join to the British army, the Indian king disband. So disband his own army and join to the British army. Second one is a British resident would stay in his capital. There will be an English representative at the headquarters of the princely state. So there must be one English representative at the headquarters of the princely government. Okay, so that is the second condition. So there will be English representative at the headquarters of the princely state. Third one is, towards the maintenance charges of the army, he should make annual payments of seed some territory permanently to the company. The king should give, which king? The Indian king. So the princely state king. So the king should give some parts to maintain parts. So the king should give some places to war to maintain the British forces and pay the monthly salaries to the English soldiers. So the king only should do the So the king should give some places to maintain the British forces and pay the monthly salaries to the English soldiers, not for the Indian soldiers. So the Indian kings should pay the monthly salaries to the English soldiers only. Yeah. After that, all the non-English European officials should be turned off straight. All European officers except British had to leave the country. That is the main condition, had to leave the country. And then the native rulers should deal with foreign states only through the English company. The king of princely state should contact with the English. Yeah, the king of the princely state should contact with the English East India Company, and then after make the some contact, some decision, and then India make a treaty with neighboring country. The British would undertake to defend the state from internal trouble as well as external attack. The English East India Company would defend the countries in the event of an attack by the foreign powers under the external attack, internal trouble. Okay, so the British would undertake, so British would protect, defend the state from internal trouble. So some other country wants trouble, the British English East India Company only defend the countries after that, as well as they defend the external attack also, external and internal trouble both.